Hello, and today I would like to talk about my new daily driver, which is iPhone 11. Today, I want to ask if the phone is worth it. Of course it is, because it's the newest stuff, and the new stuff is usually most worth it, especially when it comes to Apple, because you will get the longest tech support from all these devices. And the reason I got this phone is that I wanted to make 4K videos with my phones and have better camera and iOS 13. My iPhone 6 Plus started to feel a lot more obsolete than it did a while back. And it started to get really, really slow and sluggish. And I just wanted to get a new phone, like experience how it feels and review it and just push my videos further. So let's jump into it.
Phone is made out of very shiny glass that is kind of a fingerprint magnet, and on the bottom there is lightning port and two stereo speakers that are absolutely amazing. I'm really amazed by their quality. The sound is nice and crispy clean. On the front there is 6.1 inch LCD IPS screen with resolution of 1792 by 828. It's very nice screen, and I think it's decent enough to not recognize any pixel, and it's really good in my opinion. The A13 CPU and 4GB of RAM makes the experience of iOS 13 very nice, and it is like free, and that is expected because the phone is new. And new phones are usually lag-free if you optimize them right. And thanks to 3110 mAh battery, the phone can last whole day. I have to only charge it twice before I reviewed it. So that's very, very good. In 12 megapixel camera can shoot some outstandingly good pictures that are really, really good. And that's a reason why this is one of the best phone cameras of the year. And maybe the best out of the year, who knows? Maybe iPhone 11 is better. But this phone can also record 4K videos up to 60 frames per second, but I'm using 24 frames per second because that is more cinematic. The 12 megapixel selfie camera is also really, really good, and it pleasantly surprised me, but I don't really take selfies, so I really don't care as much. The FaceTime camera is also decent for some nice videos, and I'm pleasantly surprised, but I don't really care for them much because I usually don't use FaceTime cameras or front-facing cameras. So yeah, but it's nice improvements over my old iPhone 6 Plus.
So what I think about my new daily driver, it's an amazing phone, and I'm really happy to have one, because for me, having new phone opens up a lot of opportunities for me, like shooting better videos and stuff, and I don't see any negatives or any major negatives. One negative that I would like to talk about is small power brick, which takes a long time to charge the phone. It's not that much big of an issue for me because I usually charge my phone overnight, so the battery is good, like I said in the review. And that's it. The phone for this year from Apple is really flawless, and I'm a happy owner of that phone. So hope you like this review, leave a thumbs up or even subscribe, and for now, bye.